Well, students, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about an important topic called as types of optical fibers. Okay, so we classify the different types of optical fibers practically available into three categories: single mode step index fiber. Second category is multi mode step index fiber, and the third is what is called as a graded index or a green fiber. Okay, so how is this classification done? On what basis? So the classification is done based on the core size. First factor of classification is the core size, whether the core is small or big. Depending on that, we classify fibers. Then the second factor on which the classification of fibers is done is what is called as a refractive index profile of the fiber. Okay, so based on these two factors, core size and the refractive index profile, we classify the fibers into these three categories. Now, core size is quite simple to understand, which is the size of the core, diameter of the core. Now, what is the meaning of refractive index profile of a fiber? Now, this graph over here, what you see, is called the RI profile, the refractive index profile of the fiber. So, it's RI profile, refractive index profile is basically a graph of distance from the axis of the fiber plotted along the x-axis versus refractive index of the fiber plotted along the y-axis. Now, this graph actually is rotated by 90 degrees. Okay, it's actually, this is supposed to be the x-axis and this is supposed to be the y-axis. Why is it drawn in this way in this figure? So as to align oriented with the optical fiber so that we can show the different score and the cladding with respect to the RI profile diagram. But actually, this RI profile is actually a graph of distance from the axis. This is the zero point, distance from the axis versus on the y-axis is a refractive index of the fiber. Okay, so we will understand this when we discuss about the different types of fibers. So based on these two things, core size and refractive index profile, we classify fibers into the three categories. The first category, first type of fiber, is the single mode step index fiber. Okay, so now this is the RI profile of a single mode step index fiber. This is the cross sectional view of the fiber and this is the longitudinal cut sectional view showing the modes of propagation inside the fiber. Now, why is this called single mode fiber? Now, this fiber is, the core of this fiber, which you see here, is very small. It's about only 10 micrometers. Now, since the core is very small, the fiber can allow only one mode of propagation. The core is so small in diameter that only one mode of propagation can be allowed. Now, if you remember, while discussing about modes of propagation, we had discussed and said about this, no? The number of modes which a fiber supports, whether the fiber will support one mode or five modes or 10 modes, what does it depend upon? It depends directly on the size of the core. So, bigger the core size, the fiber will support more modes of propagation. Okay. Now, this single mode step index fiber has a very small core size. The core size is so small that the fiber cannot support more than one mode. Okay, so number of modes supported depends on the core size. So if the core is very small, so small that it supports only one mode, then the fiber is called a single mode fiber. Okay, so characteristic of a, what is the feature of a single mode fiber? The core is very small in size. Okay, so that's why single mode. Then why is it called a step index fiber? Single mode step index. Now, if you see the refractive index profile of this fiber, the entire core has uniform refractive index mu 1. Okay, so which is shown over here. Mu 1 is, now by the way, mu 1 is the core denser, then the cladding is refractive index mu 2, which is rarer, and then the surrounding outside is the, let us say, air or whatever, then mu 0 is the surrounding refractive index. If it is air, it will be 1. So, now who among the three is greater, mu 1, mu 2 and mu 0, who among the three is the greatest? Mu 1 is the greatest, then comes mu 2 and then finally is the air or the surrounding. So, that's why if you see this thing here, mu 1 is at the highest level, okay, it's the maximum. Then mu 2, the cladding is at a slightly lower level because mu 2 is less than mu 1. And then finally, mu 0 is at the lowest level, it's the least value, it's lower than mu 2, so it's this, like that. Okay, so the core region, if you see the dotted line which you are showing here, within the core, the entire refractive index is same. So, it is mu 1. Okay, it's constant. So, that's why the straight line. Constant having a value mu 1. Then, moment you go out of the core, the refractive index changes suddenly to mu 2 value. And entire within the cladding, the refractive index value is mu 2. Here also, within the cladding, the refractive index is at a mu 2 value. Again, it's a constant. That's why straight line. And finally, outside the cladding is the surrounding, which has a refractive index mu naught. So therefore, outside this line, dotted line, the refractive index changes and becomes mu naught. So why is it called step index? The refractive index changes from mu 1 to mu 2. Where does it change? It changes at the core cladding boundary. At this level, at this point, the moment you go out of the core, the refractive index suddenly changes from mu 1 to mu 2 in a single step. It suddenly drops from mu 1 constant value and drops and becomes mu 2. So the drop occurs in one single step. So that's why this fiber is called a step index fiber. Okay, because the refractive index from mu 1 from core to cladding changes from mu 1 to mu 2 in one single step. Abruptly it drops in a single step. So single mode, why? Because it allows only one mode of propagation, and that mode of propagation is shown over here. Remember, which is the mode which is always allowed? It's the mode which goes along the ray which goes along the axis of the fiber. It doesn't undergo any reflections. So however small your fiber may be, the central mode, the zero order mode, the ray which is along the center will always be there. So that's why in a single mode fiber, this is the only mode, this is the only ray direction which is passing. There are other ray directions are not there. You see the other, I've not shown any other ray directions in this thing because it's a single mode fiber. It allows only the zero order mode, the central ray, to propagate through the fiber. Okay, so I hope you have understood about the single mode step index fiber. Next type of fiber is the multimode step index fiber. Now, the single mode step index fiber and multimode step index fiber are exactly the same, except for if you see the core size. The core size is bigger here in the multimode fiber. Come see the core size here, it's very small. Here the core size is bigger. It's about greater than 50 micrometers. Okay, so that's, now since the core size is bigger, the fiber can allow more modes of propagation, because greater the core size, higher modes the fiber can support. So that's what is shown in this diagram here. The zero order mode is there, the lower order mode is there, the higher order mode are there, and there could be more also. I have shown only three in this diagram. So more than one mode the fiber supports, it allows. So therefore this fiber is called multimode fiber. And then step index, why? Because it is still, the refractiveness of the core is again uniform. It is having a value mu 1 constant. And then outside the core, it's the cladding, the refractive index is mu 2, which is less than mu 1. So again, the refractive index changes from mu 1 to mu 2 in one single step. Abruptly, it drops from core. The moment you go out of the core and reach into the cladding, in one single step, abruptly, there's a drop from mu 1 to mu 2. Because again, the refractive index changes in a single step. So again, it's a step index fiber. So multimode fiber, because it allows many modes of propagation, more than one mode of propagation. And step index, because the refractive index changes from mu 1 to mu 2, core to cladding, in one single step. Okay, now the last and important type of fiber is what is called as a green fiber or the graded index fiber. Okay, now if you see the refractive index profile of this step index fibers, whether it's single mode or multi mode, and green fibers, just compare the refractive index profile. Now you see in step index fibers, the refractive index of the core is constant, it's a straight line. Whereas in a multimode fiber, the refractive index is a curve, it's not a constant. Rather, the refractive index is maximum at the central point, zero, at the axis of the fiber. So, what is the specialty for green fiber? It's called graded index. Graded index. So, the refractive index is not constant, but it gradually changes. How does it change? The refractive index is maximum at the center, which you can see the shading which is shown. There's a darker shading in the center, and the shading keeps on becomes lighter as you go outwards. What does it mean is that the core is densest at the center, and as you go outwards, the density of the core keeps on decreasing. So refractive index is maximum at the center. So mu 1 is maximum at the center, and then as you go away outwards from the core, outward from the center axis, the refractive index decreases. Okay, so that's why it's called a graded index. The refractive index gradually is changing from maximum to a low value. Okay, in terms of the number of modes, the size of the core here and the size of the core is same. So green fibers are all multimode fibers. They allow more than one mode of propagation. Okay, so all green, we don't say graded index, step index, or graded index multimode, because all graded index fibers are always multimode fibers because they have a big core size. Okay, so the important thing is the refractive index of the core is gradually changing maximum to a low value, decreases from center outwards. Okay, so that is shown in this graph, in this RI profile. Now one special thing about a graded index fiber is that it the rays do not travel in straight lines inside the fiber. Now, when does a ray travel in a straight line? Only when the refractive index is constant. When the refractive index of the medium is constant, in that medium, the light will travel in a straight line. But if in a medium, the refractive index is changing, then the light will not travel in a straight line. It will constantly keep on bending within the fiber. Okay. So, what do you see? Therefore, the rays which travel in the fiber travel in the form of curves. And important thing is that after traveling a certain distance along the fiber, all the rays meet. If you see whether it's a central ray or the lower order mode or the higher order mode rays, all the rays meet at a common point after traveling a certain distance. Again, after traveling a certain distance forward, they again meet. Now, this is important. Okay. So, now if you see this step index fibers, what is the drawback of the step index fibers? All the rays, whether the central ray, the side lower order ray or the higher order ray, they enter the fiber at the same time. Let us assume they enter the fiber at the same instant of time. But do they come out of the fiber at the same instant? No, the central ray will come out first. Why? Because it is traveling the least distance. It's just traveling a straight line path. So it will come out of the fiber first. Then will come out is this ray, because it is traveling at a, it is undergoing lesser number of reflections. It is traveling lesser distance compared to the higher order ray. So first ray to come out of the fiber will be the central ray. Second ray will be this one, and third ray will be this one. So what happens is the rays which had entered the fiber at the same time come out of the fiber at different times. Now this is the problem. This is called a signal dispersion. What happens here? Time gets stretched. What happened here in one instant of time happens at the end of the fiber in multiple instants of time. So all the fibers entered at the same instant, but they come out of the fiber at different instants. So this is called a signal dispersion. Time gets stretched. So suppose the signal was of 1 millisecond which you had sent here. By the time the signal comes out the other side, it becomes more than 1 millisecond in time, because time gets stretched. It occurs at different instants of time. So this is called signal dispersion, and this is the disadvantage of step index fibers. Now in graded index fiber, that doesn't happen. Whether the central ray or the lower order ray or the higher order, any ray direction, they all enter the fiber and come out of the fiber also at the same time. Now why does it happen? It is because like this, the central ray is traveling the least distance. Yes, no doubt, because it is traveling in a straight line, but it is traveling in the densest part of the fiber. Remember, the fiber is densest along the axis. So therefore, the ray will travel slower, because more the density, the light travels at a lesser velocity. So this ray is traveling lesser distance, no doubt, but it is traveling the slowest compared to the other rays. So therefore, it will take a longer time. Okay. Then the second ray is traveling slightly more distance, this ray which is lower order mode, but it is traveling slightly in a lesser denser part of the fiber. So it will take lesser time. So more distance is compensated by lesser traveling time. And the last ray here, it is traveling the maximum distance. It's zigzagging quite a lot, but it is traveling its maximum distance to the least densest part of the fiber. So it will take the least time. So greater distance is compensated by lesser traveling time, higher velocity. So all the rays therefore travel, enter and come out of the fiber at the same time. So signal dispersion is very less. And therefore, that's the reason why, since signal dispersion is less, all graded index fibers are the ones which are used for digital data communication. Because in digital data, the signals are in terms of ones and zeros. So, and the ones and zeros depends on how long your time is. So this is one, this is zero, this is two ones, right? What you will say, this is one, this is zero, this is one one. Why do you say this is one one? Because this is bigger in time. So time is an important factor in digital signals. The how much big is your pulse width, depending on that, you can say whether it's one zeros, one or two ones, like this. This is one one, and these are two ones. So if time gets stretched, then it's going to be a problem. Why? Because suppose you had sent the signal as one, and by the time you reach the other end of the fiber, the signal stretches. So suppose you had sent this signal into the fiber, but suppose on the other side it becomes this much. Okay, other end it becomes this much. It becomes bigger in size. Okay, so what will happen is you will undergo a problem here. So if the signal is becoming bigger in size, you will have a problem. Why? Because you had sent one, but you are receiving one one. So you are receiving a different signal altogether. So that will create problems for you, because your signal will completely change. You are sending a signal one, but you are receiving one one. Because why? Because the time is getting stretched. So this will not happen in a graded index fiber, because the signal enters and leaves the fiber at the same time. Okay, so that's the advantage. They are used for digital data communication because the signal dispersion in a graded index fiber is less. So three types of fibers: single mode step index, multi mode step index, and graded index fibers. And among them, graded index fibers are mostly used for digital data communication because of their less signal dispersion. Thank you.